neither economics nor religious identity has influenced the Indonesian government to speak out about reports of the persecution of the Muslim Uyghur ethnic minority in Xinjiang, China. Like many other OIC countries that choose to view the situation in Xinjiang as a terrorism and extremism issue to reflect their own domestic situations at home, Indonesia often uses the Uyghur separatist movement as their main stance on the issue. Voices from important groups in Indonesia are divided on the Uyghur issue, and there has been no meaningful follow-up or action at the time of this episode. If all this is not convincing enough for Muslim-majority countries to speak out about the Uyghurs, there is yet another issue that can potentially discourage countries even more.
As China's largest provider of innovative artificial intelligence products and solutions, Face++ has launched the end-to-end intelligence security.
Beijing has developed new, highly sophisticated surveillance and security systems built on artificial intelligence that have become effective, deployable at scale, and available to countries via Chinese soft loans. Countries are now eager to get their hands on the Chinese surveillance curtain that has been deployed in Xinjiang for their own use at home.
What I worry about is that China is using Xinjiang now as basically a laboratory for sophisticated surveillance technology.
China is positioning itself to lead the world in artificial intelligence, surveillance technology.
And I can see governments around the world, including security forces in Southeast Asia, wanting to get hold of that technology, and that becoming another reason for not speaking out.
Indonesian Minister Luhut Panjaitan.
American technology is very good, but the last 5 years, I think the Chinese technology is much better.
In the age of AI, where data is the new oil, China is the new Saudi Arabia.